Hello, you're watching Proactive London. Joining me today is William Holland. He's Chief Executive of Europa Oil and Gas. William, very good to speak with you again.
It gives me back to see.
So Will, you've published a third-party report that details an updated study on emissions expected from your offshore Ireland license. Tell us more about why this report was necessary.
Yeah, that's right. We had originally had a previous report on Inishkea, which was our old main prospect. And on the back of reprocessing the seismic, which we did last year, Inishkea actually shrunk. Inishkea West increased in size, and it sort of became a 1.5 TCF prospect. The key difference between the old prospect, Inishkea and Inishkea West, is Inishkea West is higher up. So the reservoir hasn't been subjected to as much compression, which means we would expect the recovery factors per well to be better, which means you don't need as many wells to develop, to produce the amount of gas, the same amount of gas, i.e. our recovery rate per well would increase. So it was a different project. So the concept development plan now means that we need fewer wells to extract the same volume of gas, but we need a slightly longer pipeline because Inishkea West is slightly further away from the core of manifold. So you give with one hand, you take away with the other. But we wanted to sort of properly understand what implications that had to the emissions associated with any development at Inishkea West. In addition to that, the UK government recently published data on the emissions associated with gas produced in the UK. And gas produced and also consumed in the UK, so it's total consumption. And that basket of gas, you know, includes pipeline imports from Norway, from continental Europe, but also from LNG, from much further afield. And when you compare that basket of gases, say, well, that's what Ireland are currently importing through the interconnector into Ireland. But Ireland does produce gas from Corrib, and that satisfies about 25% of Ireland's domestic demand. The balance all comes from this interconnector into the UK. So when you compare Corrib gas and the emissions associated with Corrib gas compared to gas coming in from the UK, you know, you're looking at about 5.3 kilograms of CO2 equivalent per barrel for Corrib gas versus a much higher 36 kilograms BOE of CO2 from imported gas from the UK. Now, when you factor in, well, what would Inishkea West gas look like? That's even lower than Corrib gas. So that comes at 2.8 kilograms of CO2 per BOE. That's 12 times less, more than 12 times less emissions than imported gas from the UK. Now, when you think about that, you go, well, if Ireland started to produce their own gas domestically from it, more of their own gas from Inishkea West domestically, and bringing Inishkea West on, the report also said actually could satisfy nearly all of Ireland's domestic demand for 3 years. So it would eradicate all of the gas coming in from the UK. The marginal gas that the UK puts into its mix is the LNG gas. So that LNG is actually the highest emission gas you can have at over 78 kilograms per BOE. So 27 times more than Inishkea West gas. So it's a very material reduction in emissions for Ireland, actually globally, if we make a discovery in Inishkea West and bring it online.
So, I mean, the emissions report really just reinforces the case for developing Inishkea West. Is that right, Will?
That's right. I mean, it not only from a security of supply, where it says actually Ireland can be self-sufficient in its gas demand within a very short period of time, because this is infrastructure-led exploration. We can bring this into production very quickly compared to a more remote discovery, because it's so close to the core of manifold. So you bring it online very quickly, and then that satisfies Ireland's domestic demand for gas for a three-year period. And then thereafter, it's a materially more than what their current domestic production is.
Will, what are the next steps at Inishkea West as you progress to drilling?
So we are now in the full farm out mode. So we're now looking for a partner. We've got lab advisors who are specialist fallout company helping us with that. We've identified a number of companies that would be very suitable partners, and we're engaging with them now. And this is typically these processes can take 6 months, might take longer, might be more like a year, depending on how the negotiations go. But hopefully with the following wind, it's a very compelling case. Infrastructure lay, from an economic standpoint, is very compelling as well. You know, you're looking at what we expect to be a $50 million well that will return a $2.5 billion PV10 to the operator. In addition to that, it will return $10 billion taxes to the Irish government. So that's not even factoring in the multiplier effect of jobs to the local economy and County Mayo. It's a very compelling argument on all sides.
Well, Will, I hope you'll keep us posted on any progress you make. Thank you very much for the update today.
Very good to be back. Thanks. Speak soon.
I hope so. William Holland, the Chief Executive of Europa Oil and Gas.